Onto our weekly feature, Smart Farm, and the desire to reduce production costs while ensuring efficiency in farming has seen farmers turn to precision agriculture. This is an approach to farm management that uses technology to optimize crop production and involves using a range of tools such as drones and other products. On Smart Farm tonight, tea growers in Nyamira County are increasingly embracing the use of drones for commercial purposes to improve production. Our very own Dennis Satino has more on this week's Smart Farm.
At first glance, this may look like a high-flying hobby for the tea growers at Kipkebe area in Nyamira County. Well, in reality, growers here are involved in what is known as precision agriculture, the science of improving crop yields using high-tech sensor and analysis tools. Wilson Kiprotich and his colleagues at Kipkebe have embraced the use of drones to manage their tea farms.
We're involved in crop aspendry, which is tea farming. So we normally do from production of tea farming, from production to processing. When I say manual application, we were using maybe contracted some people to apply manually. So the introduction of drone came from last year, 2022. From October, we began this process with Fahari. So from that time, we have seen some changes.
Since then, the buzzing of drones over these tea plantations has been a normal affair. Drones come in different sizes, capabilities, and a wide variety of models. In farming, the technology is used for a wide range of tasks, which include crop mapping, soil analysis, fertilizer application, irrigation, troubleshooting, as well as pest management. Naima Sheikhan, an aviation professional with expertise in airline engineering, says the use of drones by small-scale farmers in the country is long overdue.
Drone use in Kenya is fairly new. We launched our regulations in 2020, so we are still 2 or 3 years in. But we see potential growth significantly, especially in the agricultural sector. It's just been a year in operation for us in the agricultural field, and we can see the clear uptake because those who've implemented it have already seen the impact in yield that has come from their farms. So I would say the growth is rapid, and the technology has to catch up.
Following a service agreement between Kipkebe Factory and Kenya Airways drone unit Fahari Aviation, Kiprotich and other growers get the drone services on a need basis. Once the drone engine is turned on, the propellers rotate, enabling flight. A remote control is used to direct its flight from the ground. The route taken is recorded by a camera, and the controller can see the image from their command position. Kiprotich has witnessed the benefits of using this technology firsthand.
Previously, when we were using the manual one, you had to require many supervisors, from the manager, the security, maybe around 5 security to cut the field. But for now, we are only using maybe a supervisor, a cut, and a tractor only. So that's the first thing we just met. Another issue, when you compare the yield we have been receiving from the manual and the drone one, the yield has improved. For instance, another field which was producing around 15,000 meti kgs per hectare has increased up to maybe around 18,000.
So far, a key concern in the use of drones lies in how they are powered.
So the current challenge is because they're fully battery powered. There are other options of having them petrol powered, but it ends up with more significant costs because of the cost of petrol that keeps going up. But when you go to the battery side, the disadvantage has been slightly on the amount of charging and the amount of battery capacities that you might need to put in place, especially if you're operating in a large-scale farm such as this, such as a tea farm or any other large-scale farm.
All in all, it is the hope that these flying machines will allow growers to become better stewards of their farms. In Kenya, the concept of using drones as a commercial product is still relatively new. But if the impact of this technology in farming is anything to go by, then increased usage remains unstoppable. Dennis Otieno, Smart Farm.